Truth Gang Gang, it's the Queen Asha Israel, a.k.a. Mama Omega, and you know I'm always bringing that truth. If you've been walking with me since day one, welcome back, and if you are new here, welcome, welcome, welcome. Be sure to let me know that you are here by putting Truth Gang in the comment section, head wraps on in the comment section, tribe vibes on the comment section, study to show thyself approved in the comment section, hashtag loyalty, and hashtag masked off in this motherfucker, because you know how we do. Gotta give my gratitude for all of your love, loyalty, and support, for booking your personal readings, and the many donations that come in as support. If you would like to show your monetary support, you can do so at $AshaIsrael. Everything is capital, but the real. If you would like to send energetic donations, smash that like button, share, subscribe, and comment. And if you are YouTube, make sure you hit the notification bell and make sure you are clicking all notifications. Let's go ahead and get our daily beautiful botanical inspiration with Asha Israel. All right, tribe, it looks like we have the pink rose, and this is going to represent grace and sweetness. Our inspirational quote of the day is going to come from Matthew Arnold, "The pursuit of perfection, then is the pursuit of sweetness and light." Ashe. There are 40,000-year-old fossil records indicating that the very first wild roses were pink ones. The first cultivated roses were also pink of color. It is known that pink roses were given in the Chinese imperial gardens 5,000 years ago. Some of the earliest known artworks depict pink roses. During the Victorian age, Danity pink roses were so popular, they inspired decorative wallpaper, stationery, jewelry, and many other fashionable items. When the pink rose was given or displayed, they conveyed gentleness and sentiments such as grace, admiration, kindness, and sweet thoughts. Our inspirational message comes from this, which is greet life with grace, even when sometimes it's challenging. Let pink roses be a gentle reminder that in order to have sweet dreams at night, you need to get in the habit of thinking sweet thoughts each and every day. I hope you guys enjoyed your beautiful botanical inspiration with Asha Israel. I love you guys so much. Thanks for joining. Leave a like, subscribe. I said share, whatever. Share up in this motherfucker. And let us know that you've been here and you enjoyed this. Truth Gang, I'm out this bitch.